Yo, this is Winds of Plague.
And you're watching barebonesmusic.com.
Yeah, get into it.
Evil G, barebonesmusic.com. I'm here with Johnny and Art from Winds of Plague. Guys, thanks for joining us. We're here at the Mayhem Fest. I've been doing my research on you guys, and what was your reaction when you found out you were going to got booked on Mayhem?
I mean, it's definitely like an unreal thing to hear that you're being put on this, like, you know, arena tour for the most part with bands like Korn and Rob Zombie. So never would have guessed, you know, we'd be here at all.
I mean, is there an intimidation factor a little bit playing with all these guys? I mean, you've toured with some of these guys, right?
I mean, I think our band's like so like focused and like out for, you know, like cutthroat. So as far as like intimidation, and we're just, no, I don't know, I think we're more just ready for it.
Yeah.
Ready to, you know, take on the stage and make the best of it.
What do you think that your guys' sound brings to Mayhem that may set you apart from some of these other bands?
I mean, we've come out of this like younger wave of bands of like Suicide Silence, Whitechapel, and Mirror and stuff like that. And really, I think we're the only band like that on this bill for the most part. I mean, we obviously have like strong influences like Hatebreed and Chimera and Shadows Fall and stuff. But as far as like the new wave, I think we're the only band out here representing that. So I guess it's something for people that haven't been exposed to that kind of music, you know, I guess we're kind of a gateway for that.
Yeah, and when the Great Stone War came out, I mean, you had that changeover. I know Kristen left, and then you got Alana in the band. What does she bring to the table as far as not only on stage, but I know you guys do some writing on tour. What does she bring to the writing process?
I think she's actually writing. She's actually...
That's a start.
Yeah, she's a start. She likes to write, you know, her own stuff on her own, but it's just a good mesh. It's just a good fit for our writing style because, you know, she'll come in and put her own two cents in after we're ready. Got structure for her. It's pretty sweet.
What we've been doing is giving her songs that are complete and seeing what she can write to it. And also Nick, our guitar player, Nick A, she writes most of the keyboard stuff anyways. Mm-hmm. So he'll also throw ideas out and she'll kind of tweak them a little bit here and there. But, you know, that was a good thing with the keyboard players, like kind of going in and out. Nick writes most everything anyway, so it doesn't really affect the band's style too much. Right. Hey, Elena, come here real quick. Come on. Oh, so did you get walk by like a jackass?
All right, into the shot of Elena. I was just asking them about you know, how you've been meshing into the band and what you're bringing to the writing process. So I know you guys write on the road and try to keep things rolling. Tell me about the spin you bring to...
Well, I'm trying to add like a little bit more like evil type sounding keyboard parts to it.
Such an evil person.
Yeah, obviously. I'm wearing Miley Cyrus clothes from Walmart. But, like, I don't know. That's, like, the kind of stuff that I write is more fantasy, evilness, orchestrated type stuff. So I'm excited to see, like, what everything else is going to turn out to be. So
going into writing this new album, taking a different approach to it as opposed to, like, the style of music. I mean, something's a little heavier. Are you trying to be, I mean, branching out a little bit?
More like the old one. Like, oh, really? Decimate the Week, almost. Like, it's a lot more show-friendly, stage-friendly, to help us on the stage. But it's good for the fans. They're going to give back to them. But at the same time, it's meeting in the middle of the latest one and the old one, I would say.
Like, the first CD, you know, was, like, very, people come out to the shows, they sing along, they right. jump off the stage, they mosh, and there's very memorable parts. And I think that's what the Great Stone War was lacking. Like, I'm happy with it as a musician, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. I think it was a... more well-written album, a little more technical, you know, the lyrics are more in-depth, but we're trying to mix the two, basically. So we want those fun elements of the first CD, but the epicness and the brutality of the second one.
Well, you've seen a lot of damage, a lot of kids get damaged out there. I mean, how's the kids out there for you guys?
We like to start the day off right, and we have been incorporating the Wall of Death, if people are familiar with that. It's like a Braveheart run at each other. And that gets pretty intense from time to time, you know?
There has to be at least 5 people that walk out with broken noses after that. Yeah. People are, like, getting trampled on the floor and stuff. I'm just like...
People don't care. They're just stomping on you.
Yeah.
So hopefully they're not, by that point, they're not drunk to the point where they won't remember us. So hopefully they're like, oh, yeah, I remember when I got my nose broken in Winds of Plague pit, you know? So.
being on a big tour like this, you know, I've also heard that you guys like to watch movies and play a lot of video games. Is that all you do on your downtime? I mean, 23 and a half hours between shows? And
This tour doesn't really have much downtime. You know, it's like you wake up, you load in, you set up merch, you go on stage, you get off and do, you know, press, then you unload merch and you eat dinner. And it's like by the time the day's over, you're like worn out. But usually, you know, we try to bring like PlayStation and play some like Call of Duty and we got Nintendo 64, so you have Mario Kart, and besides that, just movies.
I heard you play a lot of poker.
Yeah, last night it was cool, man. We had the Lamb of God guys up on the bus playing some poker, and we took their money. So
you take the money?
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's you got positive over there. You take it.
John actually bought me in, and then I lost his money, so he really lost out.
How many songs do you think you've kind of got skeletons for the new record?
There's seven or eight. Yeah, there's a bunch.
It's almost done. It's like 75% done.
I think there's like four songs left that we still need to do finishing touches on. Besides that, we're ready to go.
How are you feeling, Alana, go in and actually record on this one?
I'm excited, actually, to go and like actually record at a studio or whatever we're going to do. It was actually my first recording experience at Andrew's studio that was like more so like legit, not like at home recording my own stuff. So that was fun, and it was fairly simple, a lot easier to get my ideas down and stuff like that.
And even though you've been your touring cycle on the Great Stone War has been almost, you know, a year here pretty soon, you still have tour plans. What happens after Mayhem?
We're gonna try and squeeze in a few headlining shows around the world. We're doing like 3 weeks in the U.S., 3 weeks in U.K. and Europe, a couple Mexico headlining shows, and then hopefully that'll bring us up to the end of the year.
Yep. We just like the tour. We love it.
One last question. Who on this bill have you seen so far that's just really blown you away?
Dude, Korn. I mean, it's just a production. Zombie, Korn, Lamb of God, all the big boy bands on the big stage are just pulling out. Big boy bands.
Big boy.
Big boy. Yeah.
This is the first time you've been on Mayhem, right?
Yeah.
Yep. I mean, what does it mean to you to be on Mayhem?
Hopefully it doesn't mean it's the biggest tour of our career, but at this point it is. So, I mean, it's just, it's unreal. It's a dream come true, really. I don't know.
It's fun.
The catering's good.
Okay, this is awesome. All right, well, I'm here with Winds of Plague, Johnny, Art, Alana. I keep wanting to call you Alana. I'm sorry. Alana. And Great Stone War. They'll be going to the studio soon. Catch them out on tour. If you haven't seen them, Mayhem, we're only day nine on the tour. So
day nine?
Day nine. Yeah, no, day nine. Yeah. You're only on date number nine. So sure, check them out.